Well, all right. I am back out in the Cherokee National Forest this morning. Found this little pull off where I parked last night, and it's on this this road that's been pretty busy with traffic this morning. It is a Saturday, so I imagine there will be more people out in the forest here on this beautiful day. But yeah, I've got the next few days off, so I think I'm gonna take this opportunity to go exploring a little bit further north in the forest, further north than I've been before. At least that's the plan right now. So I'm gonna pull out here in a little while and see what happens. Well, all right, I am pretty far up this road. I've kind of lost track of how far I have come, actually. But yeah, past a number of very good camp spots for the night. But it's a little bit after 1 o'clock now. And yeah, figured I'd just settle for this spot for the time being. And I do plan to stretch the legs a little bit, maybe hike up this road for a little while. If I find a better spot up ahead, I might move the van, but this is a pretty good spot. So we'll see what happens. Yeah, on the drive up here this morning, I stopped at a little gas station on the Hiawassee River and was talking to the folks inside. They were really helpful. They were showing me some maps and telling me about some of the cool stuff I could get into up here. But yeah, the woman I was speaking to, she made an interesting comment, and it's one I've heard a few times now from a few people about these mountains. She said that you can get lost here. You can get lost here. And I don't think she meant it like literally lost, you know, like, oh, I don't know where I am, although she might have. I think what I kind of got the sense she meant was something about these mountains can, I don't even know how to describe it. It just kind of, you can just kind of lose yourself here. I'm pretty sure that's what she meant, because I have heard that from a number of different people. She said that once you get a taste of them, you can leave, but you can't really leave them behind. Like, they kind of stick with you and pull you back. And I'll tell you what, I'm starting to see what folks mean when they say that, because there is something strange and alluring about this place. And I don't know, I think it goes beyond the beauty somehow. Of course, the landscape itself is beautiful and it's inviting and all that, but I think these people are talking about something else. Some other thing that kind of pulls you and draws you back to these places, these mountains and hills. I think I know, or I think I'm starting to know what they mean by that. Well, this little pull-off worked out pretty well last night. It's pretty much just what I was looking for. It's a little chilly this morning, to be honest with you. I'm hoping it warms up a bit because I'd like to keep on exploring. Yeah, I was looking at the map and it looks like that back down this forest access road, where it meets the pavement, that road along the river where I was driving yesterday, it looks like there might be some falls up that road a little ways. So I'm thinking I might try to see if I can find that and maybe a trail or two. I'd really like to get out into these hills on a trail. Well, that was something else. That was the best hike I've had in a while. And those falls, shoot, I haven't seen anything like that in person before. So, yeah, I don't know how much further this road goes, but I might push on up it a little bit further and see if I can find another gravel road to explore. It's almost 4 o'clock, so I do need to start thinking about finding a camp spot to park. We'll see what happens. Well, there's the sun here at the end of the day. It's good to see it. Man, it is one bright sunny morning. I'll tell you what, it is just blazing through the leaves, lighting them all up. It's pretty cool. You know, kind of like yesterday where it was so cloudy. There's nothing like a cloudy day that makes me appreciate the clear sunny days like this. I remember when I was a kid, it had been like a week of just overcast skies, real gloomy, and it was really just, you know, affecting my mood. Just hadn't seen the sun in days. And then one evening, just as it was about to get dark, the clouds opened up and the sun was shining through with some blue sky, and I just went out on the porch and I just remember staring at it, and it just made me so happy after such a long overcast period to see that sun. Man, I remember that evening. Almost cried too. Yeah, so that little side road where I was parked last night, I don't know, maybe about a mile up it, it ran into this trail. I have no idea which trail this is, but it's definitely an established trail. It's maintained and well-worn. The trees are cut, the limbs pushed out of the way. I'll have to look it up when I get back into service because I like this one. But yeah, speaking of trails, on a more serious note, I didn't know this until the other day when I was looking at a map of this area, but apparently here in Teleco Plains, Tennessee, there is a section of the Trail of Tears that runs through this area. One of the routes that the Cherokee people took when they were forced out of here. I'm not gonna go on about it. I don't think there's really much I could say that would do that tragedy any kind of service. But that's a heavy thought, man. Benton McKay, trail number 2. Well, there you have it. Yeah, it looks like a person named Betty Petty volunteers to maintain parts of this trail. Thanks, Betty. Thank you. So I have made my way back to the forest access road that I was camping on the other night, closer to Teleco Plains this time. And the other day I went left at the fork in the road up ahead, but I don't know what's to the right, so I'm gonna check it out. Nice one. Well, I'll tell you what. I knew that there would probably be some kind of pull-off when I was coming down this forest road yesterday. But I was not expecting to find one quite like this. It has been pretty great. It's kind of tucked away up on this hill, away from the road. It was very quiet, very little traffic going through yesterday evening and over the night. Yeah, I don't think I could have asked for a better spot. But yeah, I think that I am fixing to head on up the road. But before I go, I do want to thank the van for getting me everywhere I've been over the past few days. As usual, the mountain mama came through once again. And yeah, thank you for coming along and hanging out. I guess I'll see you later.